In the past, H-rated tires fell into the high performance segment, and VW and Y-rated tires were classified as ultra-high performance tires, but not anymore. We'll explain why the traditional high performance segment is disappearing next. As OE manufacturers look to differentiate their vehicles with performance packages and larger wheels, the traditional high-performance segment isn't quite what it used to be. In fact, you might see finding distinctions between the UHP and HP segments is becoming less relevant. Now the HP segment has blended into the Grand Touring segment, leaving the industry with the UHP segment, both summer and all season, and the Grand Touring segment geared toward performance. So how did we get here? Well, car makers are subject to follow CO2 emission standards set by the EPA and other federal agencies. For model years 2022 through 2025, vehicle manufacturers are tasked with improving fuel economy ratings to about 36 miles per gallon. This translates to tire manufacturers adding performance characteristics to their replacement lines to match OE fitments and fuel efficiency performance. You may have even found that consumers are just accidentally falling into the high performance segment. For many consumers, they have no idea that when they buy their everyday Toyota Camry Sport or Honda Accord Sport, they will come with Z-rated tires instead of H and V or S and T as it was years ago. Consumers are often a bit surprised when they go to purchase tires and you tell them that they have high performance tire on their car. They may not consider themselves to be a spirited driver, but since they wanted the 20-inch wheels, that's what came on the car. Because of this, expect to see the performance of Grand Touring tires continue to improve in wet and winter conditions while still retaining the quiet and comfortable ride drivers expect. I'm David Sickles coming to you from the Tire Review Continental Tire Studio at Babcock's Media. Thanks for watching.